My name is Michael Trocchia, and I was arrested for stealing a $200,000 McLaren. You think you know somebody just because you grew up with them, but you have no idea what goes on through their heads. They could appear to be perfectly normal on the outside, but turn out to be a genius at illusion and a criminal mastermind.
They say this is a big rich town. I just come from the poorest part. Bright light city life, I gotta make it.
I grew up with G and Justin. As kids, G was always a pretty big risk taker. He always had nice cars, they were fast. Mercedes, 370 Nismos. I was racing. Justin and I, you know, we'd do stupid stuff together, smoke weed, vandalize. Fast forward 20 years and now I'm making videos for G Exhaust. And G comes up to me, he's like, Mike, I want you to make a video. I was like, all right, what kind? He goes, I want you to make a video of us stealing my dad's McLaren. And I was like, all right, cool, no problem. I didn't know it was gonna be legit though. We attempted to steal a $200,000 McLaren 570 and put an exhaust on it.
So how are we gonna get in?
I hope. Remember what happened last time we took this out?
G's dad owns a mechanic shop. This guy's pretty old school. As a mechanic, he worked his ass off to buy this super shiny, bright red McLaren 570S. Oh, yeah. So me, G, and Justin are gonna break in the mechanic shop at nighttime, take the McLaren, and then put an exhaust on it.
Green and red. Green and red. Green.
Got it.
All right, y'all. See you at the shop.
Checks over stripes. What are you thinking, bro? Let's do a Muffy D with a little X pipe on the side.
With G, it was always a surprise. You know, make this right over here. No, we're not going to the Wendy's, we're gonna go to the Sunoco. Always something last minute. So I was just used to it. Didn't really surprise me.
We racing a Ferrari real quick.
Oh my God.
441 drift in 2 minutes, 15 grand.
He sets up a race with one of his customers, Ferrari guy, $15,000. We're just chilling in the front, smoking cigarettes, waiting for this guy. And a cop pulls up.
What?
Cops.
What's up, buddy?
What's up, Jerry?
How are you, man?
What's
your
shop?
What's up, man?
What's this?
You don't know nothing about that.
They ran out of sight. I didn't make anything of it. I thought they were just doing it for the video. So I go inside after a few minutes, inside the office, start packing my camera gear. G walks in about 30 minutes later. He goes, what up? I was like, where's Justin? He says, Justin went to buy beers at the Wawa. I was like, all right. So we go outside in the front. There's no cop car, no Justin. Ferrari guy's pulling up. It's time to race. Pussies. Call the first one savage, mow my mood. That's what it was. 2016, we was running around. She ended up smoking the Ferrari, won $15,000. That night I was chilling on my couch, watching TV, turn on the news. I see Justin's face. He was arrested. They didn't say for what. I hit up G immediately. I was like, yo, G, Justin got arrested. He's like, what? He had no idea. I went over the next day to film the rest of the video. There was no sign of the car, and his dad was in there. So I just went home. I remember one time going for a ride with his dad in a McLaren, and he was talking about how this customer drops off McLarens, Ferraris, all these exotic cars. I wasn't really paying attention because he was pushing the car pretty hard and I was a little scared. How fast did you go in this thing?
Can't tell.
The night I went over to finish the video, I was at my house chilling. Get a knock on the door. It's like, who the hell is this? I go answer. It was a detective. He says, you're under arrest. I was like, what are you talking about? For what? He goes, Grand Theft Auto. It turned out that G never needed a video. He was just using us to help him steal this McLaren. The car wasn't even his dad's. It was his dad's customer's. They found the car buried in oil in the interior a couple days later, and it was completely wrecked. Me and Justin were released from jail 3 days later. All the charges were dropped. A lot of times people appear to be normal, but really they're just criminal masterminds hiding in plain sight.